Wow. You know, you, you have some, look at these nails on you.
Yeah,
these, no.
Oh, these
hands.
Nails?
Yeah.
I thought you meant the nails.
No. Are those actual?
Well, these are the acrylic coated. They're falses.
Uh-huh.
And the nails, too.
Yeah, no, but seriously. But those are, can you work with those? Can you?
Well, actually, I can. I've learned to do it. You know, I have a little short, fat hand, so, you know, when you have little negatives, you make positives out of them. So I've learned to button my clothes.
Mm-hmm. Can you play guitar with those?
Actually, I can, because I have an open tuning that I use. Mm-hmm.
What about the saxophone? Can you play the saxophone with those?
I wish.
Nice to see you. Oh, I've been good. You look terrific.
Well, thank you.
And upstairs earlier today, we were discussing your weight. Now, the last time I saw you, were you this weight or a different weight?
I was a little skinnier then. I was trying to balance my weight because mm-hmm. I've, you know, been doing this over a period of a few years. I got a little too skinny there for a while. Last time I saw you, I think I was down to about 100.
Might have been a little too slight, you think?
I guess. A lot of people thought so. I felt pretty good, but I weigh about 110, 111 now, and that's pretty good for my age, my height, and all that.
Yeah. So. Well, and what was it?
It's better than being a stack of bones.
Now, is that 110 without the phony nails?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. Now, let me ask you a couple of questions, and if you don't want to answer them, we won't answer them. What was the most you weighed? Can we ask that?
Oh, I weighed over 150.
150?
Yeah, about 150. Yeah. I'm not telling you any more than that.
Yeah.
But I was a little heavier than that.
And how tall a woman are you?
I'm about 5'2", if I'm really standing up straight.
Wow.
So that was a haul.
You were a little tubby. Just...
I was more than a little tubby. You're absolutely right.
But I don't remember you ever being... like a heavy person or somebody inclined to be overweight. How did this just creep up on you?
Well, yeah. I didn't actually have a weight problem when I was younger. And from when I was about 30 years old, I started to gain weight because I got lazy. I got on that bus, started eating nachos, stopping at every truck stop.
Mm-hmm.
I had some health problems.
And I mean,
I was just a hog.
You're talking about touring now. It's not just something you were doing recreationally.
Oh. With the band.
Just a bad vacation or something.
Yeah, I just bought a bus so I could go eat. Yeah.
And then it sneaked up on you and you had to knock it off.
It sneaked up on me, yeah.
Now, did you do it sensibly, reduce the weight?
It took me a long time. I've been on every diet in the world. I've done Atkins, I've done Scarsdale, I've fasted, I've done everything. But
yeah.
Now I keep my weight down by eating small amounts.
Uh-huh.
And I eat pretty much
what I want. Do you exercise?
Not much. I'm lazy.
What kind of exercise would you do if you were going to exercise? Do you run? Do you play golf? Do you?
I can't run very well. I have a tendency to black my eyes. But,
You said... Now, wait a minute. You said a tendency to blink your eyes?
To black my
eyes. To blacken your eyes. Yeah, I would think
blacken,
so.
Blacken my eyes, okay. But anyway, to be serious, I do...
Oh, yeah, let's get serious.
The bicycle's good.
Bicycle is good?
And some floor exercises,
yeah.
But I don't do enough of it.
Yeah, I'd like to see you sweaty.
Well, what did you have in mind?
I don't know. Anyway, let's talk about, I'm getting hooted now by the band. That's
hooted?
A bad sign.
Don't hoot him.
You're putting together your own band for the first time in quite a while.
Yeah, I've put together a new show with a group I call the Mighty Fine Band because they're mighty fine. And I have leased some new buses so I can go eat again. I'll probably be fat again next year. But I'm actually looking forward to it. I start a tour in May, and I plan to work for
quite
a while.
Is this going to be one of those monster tours where you're on the road every night of the year?
No, I'm going to work 3 and 4 days a week and take off every fifth week. And I'm going to do it sensible because I don't have to kill myself anymore. I've been to that before, but I do enjoy traveling, and I have missed performing. I have missed the people.
Yeah.
And we're going to open our new show. We've put together a show. Dollywood opens the 29th of April, the theme park that you talked about, and this is our fourth year. And I'm going to be performing up there.
What kind of places other than there are you going to be appearing at?
All over
big
the country.
Big stadiums or small clubs or what?
Some small places and some large. A lot of outdoor theaters. We'll probably play the fair circuit,
uh-huh.
which I enjoy that a lot.
Yeah.
And so we'll probably do some coliseums, auditoriums, and that sort of thing.
Now, that must be fun and also really grinding to be in a bus on the road, although you're going to do it in a limited fashion. But that's still got to be a lot of fun, doesn't it?
It's fun, and I enjoy it, so I'm hoping to do it. I mean, it's work, too, but it's what I do for a living.
Sure.
And I need the money. It's amazing how much it costs to make a person look so cheap. I've used it before, but it's still true.
No, but you don't think that this looks cheap?
No, this is not cheap. It may look it, but it's
no,
not.
But I don't think it does. It looks, yeah, I mean, it's interesting, different, but I wouldn't say cheap. But you're an attractive woman.
Well, thank you very much. Yeah.
We have to do a commercial. All right, we'll be back here with Dolly Parton. You're in this film. I was stunned to hear the cast of this film. Steel Magnolias is finished, correct?
Yeah, we finished it in August. Mm-hmm.
And be released shortly?
In the fall.
In the fall.
Yeah, they're having to hold off because of the Broadway show is still running.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Steel Magnolias.
Steel Magnolias.
You.
Shirley MacLaine, your friend.
Shirley MacLaine.
Right. No. I'm joking. I just had to do
it. How did you get along with Shirley?
Actually, I got along fine. I told her right up front that I didn't believe in reincarnation. Right. I didn't believe in it when I lived before. Mm-hmm. So she didn't.
Did you find yourself going home at the end of the day saying out loud, "Wow, she's goofy"?
No, actually, I got along good with all the ladies. We not only had, she had a great part in the movie. She really added a great deal to it. She's fun. And we had Olympia Dukakis. Mm-hmm. We had Daryl Hannah.
Wow.
And Sally Field. And Julia Roberts.
Yeah.
Sam Shepard played my husband. Tom Skerritt played Sally Field's husband. So it's really a big cast.
This is a big deal.
Yeah, it is.
And have you seen any of it yet?
I have seen the movie put together, and I thought it was a very good movie. Huh. And I'm real proud to be part of it. I played a hairdresser. I owned the local beauty shop. So it was so fitting for me, because if I hadn't gotten show business, I probably would have been a beautician.
How many films have you been in?
Three.
Did you ever think when your career was falling into place that you would end up being a movie star? I guess.
Well, I was open for it. I didn't go looking for it, but I figured if my career went the way I'd planned, that it would eventually lead me into that world. I honestly can say that it's very slow. I don't enjoy doing the movies as much as I enjoy other parts of my career because it's so slow.
Yeah.
But the end results are always good. I'm always proud of the stuff. And,
sure.
And I learn a lot and meet a lot of people.
Do you remember the first time you came to New York City?
Yeah. Well, actually, the very first time I was on my senior trip in 64, we came to the World's Fair. But we
senior in high school from where?
From Sevier County High School.
Sevier County High School.
Yeah. Are you from Sevier County? No.
High school graduates.
But there was...
So you came up on it with a busload of kids from Tennessee.
Uh-huh. But then I came back later, the very first time. I was so fascinated with the city then. So when I moved to Nashville in 1966 and I had some money, a little bit of money to come up here, my girlfriend Judy and I, we grew up together.
How is Judy, by the way?
Judy's good. She's backstage.
Yeah, I got a card from her last, I guess, around the holidays.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
You know Judy. You tried to get her on camera last time.
I guess we have.
But anyway, so I had a...
I don't know who Judy is.
Yeah, but Judy's my best friend.
Judy is your best friend. Well,
that's
I know.
What I was saying.
Sure.
Judy's the girl that came. We talked about her last time.
Yeah.
And she came to New York with me. Mm-hmm. And we got caught down on 42nd Avenue. We didn't know where to go. And so we were running. We didn't know. I'm serious. We wound up there. This is the truth. And we didn't know that people thought we were prostitutes. And they run in pairs because we looked real cheap. And no, we did. You know, we had all the country girls and we looked like we could be trying to make some money or something. And so this guy started trying to put the makeup on. This scared us to death.
Yeah.
And at that time, I was carrying a gun, which this story got all over the place. This was way back then. Country girls.
Oh, wait a minute. Let's go back just 1 second. You're dressed sort of like this.
Well, not. I was. I know. That's what I said. I looked the part.
You're on 42nd Street, and you're carrying a gun.
Well, I had to, because when I was coming to the big city for the first time, and, at that time, the guns were not as big a deal, and, being from the Smoky Mountains. I was looking to protect myself from them. It was mostly like for the room at night and all that.
Where the hell were you staying?
Well, we stayed at a place called the Americana Hotel back then.
Oh, yeah.
We had one room. But anyway, this
you
guy
stay there,
kept...
bring some kind of rifle, grenade.
This guy kept coming on to us and he kept he was determined he was going to have me, and I was determined that he wasn't. So
you're like 18, 19?
Yeah, about 19. And I just pushed him against the wall and took out my gun. And I told him, I said, "You touch me again, I'm going to change you from a rooster to a hen." Like the movie in 9 to 5. But anyway, then this guy recognized me.
Are you sure this wasn't an episode of Cagney and Lacey?
No, this is honest truth. And I wasn't going to tell this story, but your guy backstage had read this a long time ago, and he thought it might be fun. But I really came to promote my album, White Limousine.
Oh, yeah. All right, well, let's... Sure.
I better get out of this. I don't have a gun now, though.
Okay.
I don't have a gun, so don't nobody write me.
That's a great story, and you're lucky you came through that unscathed.
Yeah, I wouldn't have shot him, but I would have shot at the ground, and it flew, I guess.
Was Judy carrying heat, too?
Judy laughed at me. See, Judy was laughing because she'd never seen me so mad, and she'd never seen me so upset, and she thought
never
it was
seen
funny.
You kill a guy, either, I guess.
I wasn't going to kill him. I just wanted him to leave me alone.
Good to see you. Thank you very much for being here. And good luck, and anytime, drop by.
I will.
Dolly Parton. We'll be right back.